is coming down from the gallows, and I don't have very long.
My name is Christian Kuntz, and this is my story on how I went from an All-American linebacker in college to a professional long snapper for the Pittsburgh Steelers. I was born and raised in Pittsburgh. I am the youngest of three brothers. I've always loved football. We've always played football growing up. I went to Our Lady of Grace, which is a Catholic elementary school. Fifth grade, I started. On the JV team, playing outside linebacker and tight end and fullback a little bit. Once sixth grade hit, I started playing running back more, linebacker, scoring a lot more touchdowns, making plays. I was one of the better ones on the team, I'd say, and I went to Shar Valley for high school. I was starting at outside linebacker and fullback on varsity as a sophomore. That year, I actually fractured my back in the championship game, my L3. I wasn't able to, you know, after the game, I couldn't take off my jersey, couldn't get changed, couldn't get in the shower. I was in a back brace for 12 weeks. Lost all potential real, like, scholarship offers or any looks that I was getting, and then was kind of in a pickle. I didn't know where to go or what to do. I wanted to stay closer to home. Duquesne, they had a position, you know, they had a spot open to walk on, and I had some connections with, you know, the head coach and a couple other coaches on staff. They got me in at Duquesne. Walking on Duquesne and entering into training camp was tough. I thought I was coming in as a safety. I had the number 50, so immediately I knew I was going to be playing linebacker.
Very first game, we actually started him playing against Old Dominion in front of 20,000 people, full stadium, crazy atmosphere. In the very first series, he jumps up from on the line of scrimmage and intercepts a pass and takes it in for a touchdown.
I made the first tackle of the game in the backfield, and as I'm getting up, one of my teammates reached down to, you know, help me up, Reggie Island, and he'll attest to this, and he literally didn't even know my name. He, like, went down to help me up, and he looked down, he's like, what are you doing? He's like, all right, let's go. I ended up leading the game in tackles, our team and their team. I had 14 and a pick six off Heineke. And then my freshman year kind of just, you know, that was like the base of it. It just started building off after sophomore season. You know, I won a couple awards, and I was feeling real high and mighty heading into junior year. I was playing basketball in the off season during spring ball in April. And I was playing in intramurals and came down, and some kid kind of hit my knee, and I ended up tearing my ACL and meniscus. So after sitting out my whole true junior year, I came back for my redshirt junior year. You know, that year was really special, showing that, like, how much I persevered through, you know, an ACL and meniscus, a 9-month recovery process to come back and have a year better than I did before the injury. Really, you know, set the tone for going into my senior season. So heading into senior year, we had a lot of guys returning. My whole thought process, you know, we had a very good team with some talent. We started getting some scouts in, and, you know, that's rare at Duquesne. I started having agents reach out to me, and you know, my whole thought process was, I want to just have the best senior season before I even think about, you know, the next step in the process. If I have this many agents reaching out to me, and, you know, scouts coming in to see practice and, you know, see me and some other guys on the team, like, there's actually a legitimate shot. New England calls and they wanted to sign me. So I signed with New England. About 12 hours later, I got cut. So I was there for one day, I got cut, and, you know, emotions were super high, and then just shot down real quick. And that's the life of the NFL. You just have to, you know, learn how to manage that. And so that's kind of when I started, like, the transition to only long snapping. Like, I was back in Pittsburgh working, and I told my mom, I said, I think I'm done. And I applied for this sales job out in Scottsdale, Arizona. that my buddy was working for, the same company. I ended up getting the job and packing up a U-Haul and driving 38 hours to Arizona to take a sales job. I was in the middle of training and I get a call from my agent and I didn't answer. Then I got another call from my agent. Then I got two calls from my brother and didn't answer any of them because I was in this training session. I finally got a break and I went back on my phone, turned it on, had all these missed calls, texts, and called my agent back and he said, hey, New England wants to work you out and sign you. Said they were gonna sign me. They did not end up signing me. Hey, the XFL starting up, this is a time for you to, you know, if you go to the XFL, you get game film, we'll bring you back. I got six games at long snapping and right when COVID hit and the XFL like, you know, went bankrupt, not bankrupt, but you know, they just couldn't fund it anymore. The Steelers called 2 days later after our contracts got, you know, they allowed us out of our contracts and they said they wanted to re-sign me. They gave me a fair shot to compete this year in camp and the timing worked out and I had a good preseason and a good camp and I ended up winning the job and it's honestly just changed my life, you know, forever.
I knew if there was any chance that he would be a guy that could be considered for the NFL. If there was any sliver of a chance, he was going to work to do what he had to do. And that's what happened. He spent a couple years being patient, working really hard, and he was able to make it into the league. And I'm proud of him. What I would say is I'd take a Christian Kuntz again in a heartbeat or someone like him.